My name is Jalila Al Salman. I am Bahrain Teachers Vice President. I was detained on 29th of March 2011 after raiding my house at midnight, and I was taken to unknown place where it was shown to be at the end, it was the CID. I was kept there for more than 10 days in solitary confinement. I was under torture all these days, forbidding me from praying, eating, denying me using toilet, standing the whole night, and at the mid of the night they will come and will beat me with that black hose they have it. Either they will beat me directly or they will start beating the walls at the mid of the night to make me completely aware of what they are doing and to force me to hear others who are facing tortures in the same area. I was questioned there. It was very, very bad. If I want to think about it now, it's very bad really to remember that. And I was forced to sign my confessions. They refused to read, they refused that I read anything from that. Even when I asked Isa Al-Majali to have an idea or to have my lawyer to access the lawyer, he said to me, it's just you and us, and we will do what we have to do with you to extract your confessions. After that, they took me to the detention center in Isa Town, and there also they kept me for more than eight days in a solitary confinement, which was a freezing cell. And of course, all that period, I was denied any access to my family or to my lawyer. I was kept there with a very bad treatment till the date of the court, the military court, where I was taken there. I didn't know that I was taken to the court, but when I reached there, I knew that it was the court. And it was the first time for me after 3.5 months to see my family or the lawyer, who introduced himself to me as, I am your lawyer, Jalila. Before that also, they took me once to the CID where I was forced to record my testimony in front of a camera. There was a full group there who was dictating me what to say in front of the camera. And if I said anything that mismatch what they want, I will be beaten and threatened by raping. Or they said to me, we think that you forgot what happens here, and we can remind you with everything, with beating, with raping, with all that kind of thing, if things they are doing. On 7th of June 2011, I started my way with the courts. It was the military court, and there I was sentenced to 3 years in the military court. After that, I was released on bail. Then, after the verdict, also we went to the appeal court, which was just finished, and I got in the appeal court 6 months imprisonment. I'm just a sample of what happens to teachers. My colleague Mehdi Aboudib has faced something more terrible than what I have faced. He's still in detention. He's in jail prison now. He was beaten badly. He was thrown from the roof to the ground while he was arrested. And also he was kept in a solitary confinement for a long, long time. He was beaten on a daily basis. Even his nurse, that the person who was in charge of taking care of his health, was also torturing him very badly. He faced more than twice false execution to force him to sign his confessions. These confessions led to 10 years imprisonment as a verdict of the military court. And even in the appeal court, this was reduced to 5 years. Both of us, as BTA leaders, we didn't do anything wrong. We just were exercising our legitimate rights and freedom of expression and gathering. What happens to teachers here in Bahrain since then, it's very terrible to be recorded in a few minutes. I think it will be elaborated by some others very well. Teachers in Bahrain faced a lot of violations in all directions. Hundreds were were sacked from their jobs, and when they were reinstated, they were not reinstated in their positions. Hundreds were sent to court, and some of them were sentenced in the court without any warrant or without that the teachers knowing that they have cases in the court. Salary deduction is still going on. Teachers are denied from promotions or incentives for any type of punishment that they have faced for the next 2 years. Schools are not same as before now. It's anything but except the schools. It's not an environment for studying, not as before. We used to have a very good environment on study, which is safe, but nowadays it's not safe at all, since the security guards are there inside the schools, reporting teachers and the students, of course. And the bad things that we are having, we have even the school students, they are not safe inside schools. They faced a lot of, let me say, that's violations. And we hope that the world will take its responsibility in saving and protecting teachers and students in Bahrain.